looked out my window
this morning
and caught
a glimpse
of the black-eyed Susan. It was peeping out
from under the branches
of the thorny
and treacherous
bougainvillea,
which threatened to overwhelm it. The survival of the one
solitary
delicate stair
caressed by
several flowers
was a sign of hope
with some nurturing
and care.
It still had a chance
at life. I was quite
shocked
when they told me
breast cancer.
I thought
was
that
something that happened
to other women.
I'm quite fond of these.
I don't want to lose them.
Lose them?
They said
you don't have to.
They're just going to tap us
with the right one
where the cancer is,
and sew me up
with silken thread
and create a new cancer-free
woman
out of me.
I was quite
happy with the old woman.
I wasn't looking for any modifications.
Mrs. Black.
It's me,
actually.
But you can just call me Susan, if you like.
Very well, Susan. I'm Dr. Kutt. I'm the surgeon. We have test results, and I've scheduled surgery for next week.
I can't have an operation next week.
I have to finish a garden.
Ooh. Madam, you have breast cancer.
I have an exhibition in 2 weeks.
I've waited 5 years
for this opportunity. Landscape gardening is my life.
Ooh. Breast cancer surgery is to save your life.
The cancer's only early, isn't it?
The biopsy reveals a growth of around 6 millimetres.
Well, how long has it taken to grow?
3 years.
Then another 3 weeks won't make a difference.
Ooh. We can't be too careful, can we? We find it's better for the woman's psychological well-being if we operate immediately.
Ah.
I don't want you going home worrying.
Do I look worried, Dr. Kutt?
Ooh. You seem to be taking it very well. Perhaps a chat with a counsellor?
But when I saw her yesterday, I spent the whole session reassuring her.
Just trying to help.
My views should stick to surgery, Dr. Kutt, and leave the psychological stuff to other people.
Fine. I will schedule surgery in 3 weeks.
Ah, it's a date, Doc.
Hi there, Susan. I'm Dr. Burns. I'm the radio man. Radiotherapy is one of our most popular treatments. How are you feeling?
I feel fantastic. I won first prize for best sustainable garden.
Fabulous. The surgery went wonderfully well. Dr. Kutt didn't find any little nasties lurking in the lymph nodes. Radiotherapy will start next week. Darling.
But I haven't agreed to
radiotherapy.
Oh, nothing to worry your pretty little head about, darling.
I'm not
just
worried about it.
Just say that the procedure after every breast cancer surgery.
I just don't want it.
Oh, Dr. Kutt is an excellent surgeon, but he might have missed a little bit.
It was so small.
I'm surprised.
I even found it.
We can never be too sure about these things, can we, darling?
Would you please stop calling me darling?
Sorry, darling. Just being friendly. Let's look on the positive side of all this business, shall we? Radiotherapy is like having a mini breast reconstruction. It tightens the breast tissue. Some women would kill for that.
And some men.
Maybe I should have the other boob zapped so that they'll match.
That's the spirit.
Quack, coo, coo. I'll make a deal with you, Dr. Burns. If you hold my hand while they burn my breast, I'll do it.
No. I can't do that. That would expose me to radiation. Excessive amounts can cause cells to mutate,
which then develop into tumours
called
cancer.
Goodbye, Dr. Burns.
Mademoiselle, Dr. Burns has informed me that you have refused radiotherapy. Nobody ever refuses radiotherapy.
I'm not nobody, I'm me.
And I am the chemo man, Dr. Poison. And I recommend very strongly that you have the chemotherapy.
What would that do?
Sometimes the cancer cell, they're lurking, waiting to destroy. The chemo will sweep them away.
Won't it damage the healthy cells?
Your mouth may become ulcerated, your toes could turn black, but if this happens, we know that it is working.
Well, that's something to look forward to.
Will I lose my hair?
But we'll grow again, no? And in the meantime, there are so many wonderful things for you to put on your head. The other day when I was shopping, I saw some very attractive scarves. They were very sexy.
Being bald is not sexy.
You have very beautiful black eyes, Suzanne.
Dr. Poison, are you married?
I am, but that doesn't have to matter.
If you find bald so sexy, why don't you give your wife a few doses of chemo? It might improve your marriage.
But
How can you suggest such a thing? Chemotherapy can make you sick, very sick. You are a crazy woman.
Hello, Susan. I'm Dr. Peddler. I'm the medical consultant.
Ah, they've brought in the big guns, have they?
Could you please explain to me why you have refused all treatments recommended by my esteemed colleagues?
Because I prefer more natural methods.
Like positive thinking?
Scientific studies have indicated that positive thinking has no outcome on survival.
Well, let's just prescribe a mega dose of negativity then, shall we?
There is an alternative. We could give you a drug called tamoxifen.
And what will that do?
It will strip all the estrogen from your body.
And what effect will that have?
You will enter an early menopause.
But I'm only 32!
You will have hot flushes.
A dry vagina.
Low libido.
Heart disease. Blood clots and infertility.
Wah, 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 wah.
If I told you to take a drug
that stripped all the testosterone
out of your body,
would you take it?
Would you?
Would you?
Would you?
Doesn't exist.
If I told you that it would interfere
with your libido,
then you have an erection, cause infertility.
There's no need to threaten me.
When I started taking the pill, I knew it would increase my risk
of breast cancer.
How dare you suggest it? I give my wife the pill. Do you think I'd give her something that would cause breast cancer?
I don't know. Would you?
Would you?
Anyway, why isn't there a contraceptive pill for men?
Pharmaceutical companies trial one, but the men complained about the side effects.
Wah, 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 wah.
Susan, I am Merely Probe. I'm the psychiatrist. How are we today?
There is no we, there's only me.
I don't have a split
personality.
I hear, however, you're having problems with my male colleagues.
I don't have any problems with them, Dr. Probe.
I just don't believe in their treatments.
Well, they are the experts, dear.
Would you please stop calling me dear?
Sorry, dear. Bad habit of mine. Now, I think you are in denial about your cancer.
Oh,
dreadful bird. About how sick you really are.
I don't feel sick at all. I think your doctors are trying to make me sick with their so-called cures.
You make it seem like a conspiracy. Why would these wonderful professional men want to make you sick?
We're here to make you well.
I think you want to keep me sick for as long as you can.
If everyone was well,
then doctors wouldn't have a job.
And the pharmaceutical companies wouldn't make any money.
Sometimes when people are depressed, their thoughts become twisted and they begin to imagine things that are not really there.
I pared back and fought off the bogeyman, which had threatened to overwhelm the black-eyed Susan.
I had given her a charm. I lied. I fed and sustained her with juices and organic nutrients. I nurtured her with love, meditation,
and music,
and much laughter.
The bougainvillea had given up its fight for dominance.
Was in remission,
and had retreated to the back fence.
The black-eyed Susan was renewed,
awash with a myriad of growth,
and potent
with the promise of a glow.